North Florida to meet to see who is going to be named the best bricklayer in the state of Florida.
We are back in stall number one with Mason Bob Ball. Bob Ball is one of these guys that we see perennially every year. In fact, interesting story about him. Bob has actually competed 8 times in national bricklaying competitions. He actually holds the world record in the Guinness Book of World Records
for most times.
That's right. Yeah, Bob's giving us a little bit of jazz. No surprise, he's so calm in this competition. He's already got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 course lead built in just a few minutes of this competition. So you can really see that speed and skill is really, really important to him. Here at stall number 3, Mr. Reed Morris Sr. This is another name that is pretty familiar to this competition. We just mentioned about the size of the lead some of these guys are going to be building. 5 seems to be the magic number over the first 2 stalls. It looks like Reed's going for 6 if I counted his brick correctly. So every one of these courses is double white, which means it's got 40 on both sides of the wall. That is 80 total brick to lay from left to right. 80 brick per course is what he's shooting for, is what he's gonna have to have. So as he is laying this brick, 6 courses, it's going to put him, let's see, 6 and 8, 480 brick right off the bat he's gonna be able to fill in. Stall 4, Mr. Chris Labrie. He's competed a couple of times before, so he is not a new face, and it's showing right now. In fact, this is probably the fastest I've seen him move in the last 3 years he's been doing. So obviously a lot of practice has gone into what he's got going on here. Chris actually took a different technique. We mentioned before, 6 is the highest lead we've seen so far. 5 seems to be the standard. Chris only going 2 at a time. He's taking his time and going ahead and filling in the walls. To be honest with you, if you're laying in this competition and you're looking up, what you're going to see is Chris laying a whole lot of brick in the middle of the wall. It's going to be a little bit intimidating for some of these guys. Last stall we came to, but first in our hearts, Mr. Adam White.
Stall number 5.
This is Adam's 4th time competing. He's been to Vegas before. He's excited to give it another shot.
Yeah.
Take a long shot all the way down to the end. You can see exactly how high that lead is. He knows he's going to be laying a lot of brick today. I think the goal was around 600, 650. Really, all he cares about is making sure that these bricks are clean, right? No deductions.
Yep.
That's really the goal today. Side first and then the working side. Typically we'll see a guy lay the entire back side of the wall and then the entire front side of the wall. So a little bit of a different technique. Not exactly sure the concept behind this. I'll be excited to talk to him after the show.
Well, actually the reason I'm doing it this way is so that my mortar, once I spread half the wall, my mortar isn't all the way hard by the time I get to the other end.
See, that certainly makes sense. It's almost 90 degrees here in Panama City. He's afraid that if he gets, uh, he gets an entire wall spread, especially on a brick like this, is what they call in the industry a bit of a sucker, right? It's a real porous, it's sucking a lot of moisture out of the mortar. So he's only spreading half the wall at a time, it sounds like, to make sure that that mortar doesn't set up ahead of him. Really good idea. It's gonna help him out, I'm sure, in the long run.
Thank you.
looked like the mud got a little bit dry on him. He absolutely beat that brick down to make sure it was gonna land. Really cool to see these old Marshalltown trowels. This one's not even that old, but it has that old school feel with that wood handle. Very, very cool to see out here in the competition. But really, really cool move he did here. His bed joint was a little bit thin. He did not have enough to hold the brick up, but his hand was so soft as he set the brick, he was able to make it float right on top of a mortar bed that didn't have quite enough mortar. So really impressive when you see guys who do this for a living. They're able to actually float the gap when they get in that situation. So really, really neat to see. SPEC MIX is, it's in the blood. And I'll tell you what, this is the second guy I've seen out here today literally giving blood, sweat, and tears running down his arm as we speak.
I'll be crying later.
Sir, lotion is what we suggest if it gets that dry out here.
Yeah.
But yes, absolutely incredible. I'll tell you what, smooth trowel motion is so incredibly important. It's something that these guys are making look easy, but the actual trowel manipulation is the hardest part of this job. So really fun to watch these guys be able to spread. You saw him running down the wall while he spread it. It almost looked like he was shaking hands. That's really the motion these guys are looking for, right?
Yeah.
Trowel out, turn to the side, just like shaking a hand, straight down. So really cool to see these guys being able to make it look so easy.
You gotta think of it as an extension of your body.
Exactly.
Right. Finger, hand, foot, whatever you can get you to understand it. You can't feel the tip of it, but you know where it's at.
Down to Panama City to be able to start this competition down here. So again, very, very cool to have guys like that in the industry supporting everyone.
Yep.
get it before I get in it.
That's right.
Hey, man, it's Mason.
Josh, we have the victory. 10 minutes left in the competition. 10 minutes.
Then we'll see guys move their trowel from where we're looking at, the left to the right. Jody's actually going from right to left. That's a motion he's obviously comfortable with, and he's able to hit that clip point. So again, a lot of these guys see some very different techniques, job site to job site.
How many minutes do we have left?
We got 5 minutes.
5 minutes, guys, keep it up.
5 minutes left to go with the competition.
Can I take a coffee break?
Bobo, the pace you've been going, I'm not sure if you need caffeine. Everything is exceptional.
Thank you.
Guys take the trowel and they'll run the tip across the bed joint so they can furrowing the mud. It's helping to rig the front and the back side of the brick together to make sure that it floats nice and even on. Again, we're looking at a master, a guy who doesn't even have to furrow the mud. He's able to just set nice and soft, float that brick right into place.
All right, we have officially
4 minutes.
4 minutes left. Guys, 3 minutes.
Someone get me a hall board over here.
I'll be honest with you, Chris's pace is very impressive. At this point in the competition, between your lower back and your forearm, everything is absolutely on fire. So really impressive to keep the pace this guy going right up. And look at that. The last brick landed perfectly. It is so hard. We've seen a lot of people having to adjust this brick as they land at the end of the wall. Chris landed that one absolutely perfectly. Today, honestly, that's what keeps this industry alive, right? It's not how many brick you can lay on a real job site. It's how well you can land. So really, really fun to see this. A guy that can lay a lot of brick and lay them well. Any of these gaps you're seeing without mortar, so still got a lot of work to do. But again, really, really impressive hole.
Three, two, one, Trevor's down.
Ladies and gentlemen, if you saw that trowel, that Marshall
drop to the floor, you know that that means this competition is over. We've said it. I've seen three people out here today giving blood, sweat, and tears. You hold up that right arm, you let them know. This way, yeah, what it took for you today.
So we have entered the tooling period. This is where we give these guys about 20 minutes to be able to fill in and make this wall nice and sellable, which is really the goal. Again, we talked a little bit about it, but it's very, very important on a job site to make sure that the wall is something that the owner is going to be happy with.
Yep.
It's actually what keeps the industry going, right? Quality. That's really what we're looking for.
That's what
This exact portion right here, we're watching these guys go back, strike a lot of heads. In fact, a lot of times when these guys are talking, they'll say a term, head before bed. That's something that you can help you remember, right, what you're wanting to strike in general.
Yep.
What you'll see, we're going to back out just a little bit, and what you're going to see is the tender's keeping a little bit of mud on the board ahead of him, some nice loose mud. He's able to fill in any gaps or what we call voids in this wall. What he's also done is in his left hand, you can see a tape measure, right? He's gonna take his time and point out any voids he sees to be able to fill it in as you go. So this part seems like the easy part after all the work these guys have just done. But truth is, they still need some communication to make sure they're filling in any voids that they see. Done this for a living, this is what you're looking at, right? He is using what we call the old hand trowel. He is putting that mortar directly in his hand as he's joining it out. Often what you'll see is a guy take a trowel just like this, they put a glob of mud right on the front, and they'll fill in as they go, right? So they don't have to put it on their hands. This is a guy who has lived it, loved it, breathed it, eat it, the whole thing.
We got poor Bob a little bit nervous now, standing right on top. Again, it looks like he's caught a lot of these head joints up.
Hi guys, we're 5 minutes in for the tooling portion of the program. So while we're turned on, we've got a ton of pizzas up here. It's basically all pepperoni, but still. If you like it, come on up. That's competitors, that's spectators, fans, family, you name it. So come up here under the Ford and the Spec Mix tents and grab yourself something to eat.
For those who cannot hear at home, we're almost halfway.
Thank you.
Looks like he's going to be in pretty good shape. He was able to fill quite a bit of this front side of the wall, so he's actually on pace, which is really, really good.
We will start off right now with announcing our third place finisher, which is Reed and J.R. Morris out of Morris Masonry and Construction. We would like to go ahead and announce second place, which is out of stall number one, Bob Bull and Jeremy Andrade.
Congratulations.
Craftsman Award goes to stall number 5 out of Brunette Masonry, Adam White and David Mond. I will go ahead now and announce the first place competitor who has yet to leave the stage right now. Adam White, David Mond.
Hey, buddy, you're going to have help holding the level, holding the checks, holding the trout.
Good work, Adam.
I am here with the winner, Mr. Adam White, of the bricklayer competition in Panama City, Florida. Give me an idea, man. How's it feel? Are you excited about getting to go to Vegas?
Yeah, I'm excited. It's, I'm anxious already.
Oh, I can imagine. No, but this is not your first time there.
No,
yeah?
This will be my third time, and actually third time in a row.
That is awesome.
So I guess now I'm a 3-time in a row Florida regional bricklaying champion.
Right, fantastic. Okay, so we're excited for you. Are you going to do any practicing, or did you do any practicing for this competition?
I did about 2 hours last night.
Okay, so,
but yes,
so no is what he's trying to say.
I normally do practice.
Yeah, yes. Okay, that's awesome. Is it just leads, or are you practicing an entire wall? What are you trying to accomplish when you're doing it?
Normally I practice my leads and a short section of wall. About what the junior bricklayer.
Yeah, it looks like. I think
try
it's
not
great.
To burn myself out till I get there.
Listen, we don't normally do it, but let's bring in the tender real quick. Did you get to practice with him?
Not much.
No, just on
we
the wall
together,
every day? Yeah, I hear you.
Exactly.
Okay, good. What's your name for everybody at home?
My name's David Mond.
David, very, very happy to have you here. Congratulations, guys. We're excited to see you out there. Do you have a goal number? Like, what do you got to lay when you get out there?
I want 600 perfect.
600 perfect is a heck of a goal. Listen, congratulations.
Thank
again.
Appreciate it.
Thank you so much, guys. We'll see you guys in the next one.